Hello friends, welcome to a new lecture today. In this lecture, I would like to explain about uterine curette. So uterine curette, if you see, it is a straight instrument, and if you see, it has two ends. The two ends of the uterine curette are broad ends, and if you see, there is one fenestration which is present at the broad end. In the broad end, there is a fenestration, and here if you see, there are no serrations. But if you see the anterior vaginal wall retractor, which is similar to this uterine curette, so here if you see, there is it, even this is a straight instrument, but here there are two broad ends, and on the broad end there is a fenestration, and there is also serrations here. But here if you see, there are no serrations. That is the only difference between the uterine curette and anterior vaginal wall retractor. So this uterine curette can be of four different types. If you see, one, there is sharp end on one side and blunt end on the other side. Uterine curette, if there can be sharp end on one side and blunt end on other side. Sometimes you can see sharp or blunt ends on both the sides. Sometimes you can see a handle like this and a sharp end. Sometimes you can see a handle and a blunt end. If there is a handle and a blunt end, then it is called as flushing curette. Now let us learn about the uses of uterine curette. First we will learn about the uses of uterine curette based on the types of uterine curette. So as I have said, if it's a sharp curette, then it can be used for endometrial biopsy in cases of infertility or dysfunctional uterine bleeding or tubercular endometriitis. If it's a blunt curette, it can be used to suspect choriocarcinoma, and for suspicion of endometrial carcinoma, we can use this blunt curette. For suspicion of choriocarcinoma and suspicion of endometrial carcinoma in endometrial biopsy, we can use this blunt curette. And then if it's a flushing curette, it can be used following DNC. And there is one more curette which is called a Charmin curette, where the curette has a blunt end on one side. On one side there is a blunt end, and there is a bent end, and then fenestration with broad end. It is used in infertility workup when only one strip of endometrium is enough for hormonal reflection. So it is used for taking one strip of endometrium, and it is used in infertility workout. Now there are some questions which should be asked, which can be asked when you pick up this instrument. One, in infertility, we'll have to do endometrial biopsy. Now, when are we going to do this endometrial biopsy? This endometrial biopsy, it is done on day 21 or 23rd. I'm sorry. This is done in day 21 to 23. Between those 3 days, we can do this endometrial biopsy if cycles are regular. If cycles are irregular, then it can be done within 24 hours after the menstrual cycle, after the menses. So this is about the curette. So this uterine curette instrument, it is held like a pen like fashion, and we introduce it into the cervix and then to the uterus, and you will just take a small part of the endometrium through this hole, and this endometrium, it is sent for biopsy for histopathological examination. So this is about the most important instrument, that is uterine curette. Thank you guys for watching my lecture. Thank you.